My name is Candice Hong. I am a graduate student here in the pharmacology department at UCLA, and I'm part of the Christofk Lab. The lab works on this field called cancer metabolism, and our research focuses mostly on breast cancer. Right now, a lot of cancer drugs can be very generic, so it harms normal tissue as well as your cancer cells. So we're looking for specific targets that will only target the cancer cells. I grew up actually all over the place. I was born in Korea, but my dad actually went back to school after I was born, so we moved to Canada, and we ended up moving everywhere. He ended up getting a job, and then we ended up in California. I'm a scientist because my dad was in science, and I think it was just a natural following in his footsteps. I first became interested in science not in high school. It was my favorite subject, but not my best subject. And I think that's why I pursued it, because it was challenging. I'm actually not very good at math. You don't have to be good at math to be a scientist. You just need to be able to learn well. You don't have to be good at math. What motivated me to become a scientist? Initially, when I started, it was just an intellectual curiosity. I just wanted to know how our bodies work and what these diseases are, how we can fight them, how we can help people. It became a little bit more personal when my husband was diagnosed with cancer last year. So it made me rethink about how important our work is. My scientific life in lab, I work on a protein called monocarboxylate transporter 1. Right now, we're just doing experiments to figure out what its role is in breast cancer. We can do experiments where we remove this protein from the cell and then see what happens to the cells. Are they functioning in the same way, or are they changing? Most of the equipment I use in lab have to do with cell culture work. Since we can't do these experiments in people, we have to use some sort of model to do it in. So we do them in the cell culture work, in the cells that we grow in the lab, and we can manipulate them to see how they react to the drugs that we give to them before we actually give them to real people. All of these experiments help to determine what the protein I'm working on does in the cells and whether or not it is a viable target for cancer therapy. Lab life, I think, is very different than the people generally think it is. We do work independently on our own experiments, but we also spend a lot of time talking to each other, asking each other questions, and getting help from one another. We also spend surprisingly a lot of time socializing. Lab life is definitely a second family.
Hi.
Because you spend so much time there.
Did you go to UCLA undergrad too?
Abby and I both did. We were the same year and the same major.
Really?
Yeah.
And you just get to know the people you're with, especially as a graduate student. You're here for 5 years, 5 to 6 years, so you work with the same people for 5 to 6 years. You get to know them pretty well. My hopes and dreams for the research I'm working on is that the drug that we're testing in lab actually ends up being used for cancer patients, and that it actually helps save some lives. There have been recently a lot of articles about how hard it is to be a female scientist. I want to disagree. I've had 2 kids in grad school. Don't let family work-life balance deter you from going into science, because I have a very flexible schedule and I spend a lot of time with my family, and I also get work done, so it's very possible. If you are considering a career in research and science, I would say go for it. If you're curious enough and you're persistent, you can do it. You don't have to be good at math or science, you just have to be tenacious.